Hello everyone, this is Jeff of TAOFLEDERMAUS. We have something very cool to show you today. These are what we call turbine rifled shotgun slugs. A professional machinist named Tim Hamilton contacted me and said, hey, I made these rifled slugs for you out of aluminum and I'd like you to shoot them. A year or so ago, a channel called Artisan Tony made us some 3D printed shotgun slugs or bullets.
Wow.
But these had some stability issues. They tumbled around, and a lot of viewers suggested, hey, those things need to have rifling on there to make them spin. Okay, that makes sense. So Tim Hamilton decided, hey, I'll make some aluminum slugs with rifling built in them, which will cause them to spin as they travel through the air. And that, of course, is what keeps a normal bullet flying straight through the air, the gyroscopic stabilization. And Tim went as far as designing these with three different twist rates. And a twist rate is simply how far it has to travel to make one complete revolution. In this case, it has to travel 10 inches to make one revolution. Now these rounds look very promising. They're very precisely made, balanced. All the fins are perfectly spaced. There's six milled slots in each one, and each round weighs 7/10 of an ounce, or about 20 grams according to the scale. Each round is basically a 70 caliber slug, 2 inches long, and that's a 50 caliber bullet, just for comparison. So now's the moment of truth to test these things out. Very excited to try them. They load very nicely into this Mossberg 590 smoothbore shotgun with a 20-inch barrel.
Okay, shot one. Hit it.
Hit it. So far it looked pretty promising. Darren hit the target. Target was approximately 20 yards away, but it landed on target.
Hit it. Oh man, you hear that ricochet?
Yeah.
Hit it.
Let's see how it does using a Rio high brass round.
Wow.
And then for the final shot, we'll go back to the Piochi low brass using the 1 in 20 twist slug.
They're hitting. That's a good thing.
Yes, Darren was able to hit the target every single time. Not the smallest of targets. Each target was approximately the size of a sheet of paper, 8.5 inches by 11. And you can see the various impact points and some of the damage caused by these slugs. The final slug actually went through this computer hard drive and halfway into the phone book that was put behind it. Now this is the only slug that we actually found. The other ones ricocheted off in different directions. We may be able to find those at a later date, but you can see how the nose of it is very smashed. So that's promising. It could have been flying straight. The fun part for me is coming home and watching the high-speed footage and seeing what actually happened. Now we've got three high-speed cameras. They're Casio EXF1 Pro high-speed cameras, and we're shooting at 300 frames per second. This is 600 frames per second, and then 1200 frames per second. Sure, they're not Phantom high-speed cameras costing in excess of $400,000, but they're great for field use like this, for field testing. Now if you remember, this shot is the one that when it struck the plate, it kind of sung. It actually sounded like a turbine. It just zing. And you can see how the slug hit the bottom and shot upwards at a high velocity. But consistently, the problem we're seeing is the rounds are tumbling. Yeah, they're more or less staying on target. There's a slight deviation in trajectory, but for the most part, they're keyholing and flying sideways or tumbling around. But this kind of gives you an idea of how complex supersonic aerodynamics really is. What you think would work doesn't always work. But in the past, we've had some very good success with some rounds made by a channel called HW97 Carbine. And yes, we will be showing a few more of his rounds in the very near future. You know, there's a saying that goes, if you aim at nothing, you'll hit it every time. So I definitely appreciate when people have enough curiosity to make something like this, because you never know what it's going to do until you actually take it out and try it. So it's folks like HW97 Carbine and Tim Hamilton who are generous enough to with their time to allow us to try some of the rounds that they design. And speaking of Tim Hamilton, he was kind enough to make a video on how he made these, how he designed them, showing some of the machining, the machine tools, the very sophisticated CNC process. And please check out his video. He's got other ideas in store too. So it might be a good idea to subscribe to him and see what kind of ideas he's got up his sleeve. I definitely want to thank him for all this hard work. I wish they would have worked, but hey, we at least learned something. So if you got any suggestions for Tim, go to that video and tell him your thoughts. Thanks for watching.